just after about 1200 before Christ, a very mysterious thing happened in the Mediterranean world. About that time, all of the civilizations in that in and around the Mediterranean suffered a collapse for reasons that we still do not even know. Among the people who suffered this collapse were the Mycenaeans. This was a Greek culture located sort of on the southeast of Greece. And it was the Mycenaeans, really, who developed a civilization that celebrated warriors. And from all the stories that we get from the Iliad and the Odyssey, all of those were stories about Mycenaean people: Achilles, Menelaus, Agamemnon, Odysseus, all of those that you have read about in school. So that civilization kind of died out, again, for reasons that we don't know. And then shortly after that, Egypt was invaded by a people that were depicted by the Egyptians with unusual costumes. And the Egyptians called these the Sea Peoples. And they very nearly conquered Egypt. But Egypt somehow was able to hold out and keep from being conquered. But what we can learn from the Egyptian hieroglyphs is that these people, having been repulsed from Egypt, settled in other regions nearby. And one of these was the Holy Land. And we think our best evidence, our best guess, is that the Philistines were connected somehow with these roving Greek seafaring people. And the material culture that archaeologists have unearthed from the Philistine cities of Ekron and Gaza, those bear very close resemblance to the Mycenaean material culture that archaeologists have found in Greece. So when we hear the Bible talk about the Philistines, maybe to get the picture, you should think about the early war. Think about the battle between Achilles and Hector, this single combat idea. And that's exactly what lies behind our story for today. This is from 1 Samuel, the 17th chapter, and it's a very long story, so we're leaving out a little bit of it, and we'll get to the major story. Now, the Philistines gathered their armies. There came out from the camp of the Philistines a champion named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. He had a helmet of bronze on his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail. The weight of the coat was David rose early in the morning, left the sheep with the keeper, took the provisions and went as Jesse had commanded him. He came to the encampment as the army was going forth to the battle line, shouting with a war cry. Israel and the Philistines drew up for battle, army against army. David left the things in charge of the keeper of the baggage, ran to the ranks, and went and greeted his brothers. As he talked with them, the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, came up out of the ranks of the Philistines and spoke the same words as before, and David heard. David said to Saul, "Let no one's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight for this Philistine." Saul said to David, "You are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are just a boy, and he has been a warrior from his youth." But David said to Saul, "Your servant used to keep sheep for his father, and whenever a lion or a bear came and took a lamb from the flock, I went after it and struck it down, rescuing the lamb from its mouth. And if it turned against me, I would catch it by the jaw, strike it down, and kill it. Your servant has killed both lions and bears, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be like one of them, since he has defied the armies of the living God." David said, "The Lord, who saved me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear, will save me from the hand of this Philistine." So Saul said to David, "Go, and may the Lord be with you." Saul clothed David with his armor. He put a bronze helmet on his head and clothed Yeah. just a small church, and they knew what their mission was, and they were able